Welcome to the very first Harlequin Live broadcast. Today we're very excited to welcome JT Ellison into the office. Welcome, JT.
Thank you for having me.
Today we're going to do a little Q&A with JT. We're going to get to know her and her mysterious stories a little bit better.
Yay. Hi, Facebook.
Hi, Facebook.
Hope you guys are having a good day.
Yeah. So first question, we are so excited about the mass paperback release of Field of Graves on November 29th. Why do you think fans of Lieutenant Taylor Jackson and Dr. Samantha Owens should add this book to their reading list?
I think everyone will be thrilled to find out that it is the origin story for Taylor and Sam. And it's also how Taylor meets Baldwin, which is very important to the rest of the series. But it has a twist. Sam is the lighthearted, carefree character, and Taylor is the one that's having personal issues. So it really flips the two series on their ears, and I think it's a lot of fun for people to, you know, see their characters out of character.
Ooh. I can't wait to add it to my reading list. Next question. We have a lot of All the Pretty Girls fans in our audience. What's the one thing that surprised you about the reader response to this book?
I think that it was the attraction to darkness. I expected people to, you know, have a problem with that, and instead they apparently are a bloodthirsty bunch and really wanted more of it and wanted to you know, continue the series and continue getting into the darkness, and they like the darkness, and so that's, I'm happy to go there, but it was a really big surprise.
Speaking of darkness, with Halloween right around the corner, it's a great time to read spookier, more intense thrillers. What is it about darker stories that appeals to our imaginations so much?
I think there's an element of there, but for the grace of God, go I. That we can read about these horrible events in relative safety and feel comfortable that we aren't going to, you know, have somebody crashing through our doors and hurting us. So we get that kind of atavistic thrill from it. But at the same time, you know, I think it's important for people to look at how awful people can be to one another and take something from that and say, I'm not going to be like that. So hopefully that, you know,
hopefully
you get
not.
Both ends of this.
Fantastic. Ooh, this is a good one. What's one thing your fans might be surprised to know about you?
There are so many things.
Where do we start?
I am a complete introvert, which nobody ever believes. But I think the thing that nobody really knows, I'm a golfer, and I really, really feel the most at home when I'm off my laptop, when I'm on the golf course. So it's a really good stress reliever for me, and I'm big into yoga and that kind of stuff. But yeah,
have you tried hot yoga?
I have not, because I don't like being hot. I grew up in Colorado, where it's nice and cool, and I like it to be cool. I don't think I can handle it.
It's the opposite here.
Yeah, I know. I was kind of excited. The weather here was really crappy today. Yes. I was like, yes, cold weather.
Oh, another good one. If you could spend a day with any author, historical figure, or alive today, who would you choose?
Hands down, Hemingway. I would absolutely, I mean, to sit and listen to his stories and to talk to him about the craft and about writing and about how he thinks through his story and the dedication and sacrifice that he made, mm-hmm. I think that would be absolutely spectacular.
Do you have a favorite Hemingway novel?
I love some of his short stories, and Hills Like White Elephants is one of my just all-time favorites. It really impacted me when I read it, and I've just actually gotten back from a Parisian tour where I walked in all of his haunts and you know, wrote in all of his haunts and really tried to do that. So yeah, I'm kind of obsessed.
Not a bad person to be obsessed with.
No, not at all.
And last question, what's the last book you couldn't put down and would recommend to readers?
I have to recommend Daniel Silva's The Black Widow, which is his latest Gabriel Alon, and I know it's a part of the series, but you can pick it up and read it without having read the rest of the series. It is brilliant and topical and one of the scariest and best thrillers I have ever read. And also, Laura Benedict has her new book out, The Abandoned Heart, which is the third in her Bliss House series. And they are incredible books, kind of perfect for Halloween, very spooky and dark, and you'll absolutely love them. Haunted House Stories, just perfect.
I'm gonna add that to my reading
list. Yeah, you'll love her.
So thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, this time around, we weren't able to take questions from our Facebook audience, but be sure to leave your questions in the comments and we will pass them on to JT to answer later.
Absolutely. Happy to.
And be sure to look out for Field of Graves and other great JT Ellison titles. And if you like great mystery novels, be sure to follow JT on Facebook. I know you run your own Facebook Lives quite often.
I do yeah. Some Facebook Lives. So you can hop over to JT Ellison 14 and check them out.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And tune in on Monday when we'll be sharing another great broadcast with spooky author Gina Showalter.
One of my favorites. Thanks, you guys. Nice to see you.